Hello, boys and girls. Gather round, gather round. It's story time, and our story today is entitled Bouncing Back. Once upon a time, there was a bouncy ball. And do you know what happens when a bouncy ball hits the ground? That's right. It bounces back. And that's because bouncy balls are made of rubber. So, when the ball hits the ground, it flattens, then quickly changes back to its original shape. And this is the motion or change that makes the ball bounce back. And sometimes, boys and girls, things happen in life that make us feel a little flat, like a bouncy ball, when it hits the ground. Think about when you feel sad, or mad, or even worried. But just like a bouncy ball, we all can bounce back too. And this ability to bounce back is what we call resilience. You see, boys and girls, sometimes we make mistakes or bad things happen to us. And these things can make us feel upset. Can you imagine that yesterday I spilled paint on my favorite shirt? And don't you feel worried at times when you can't figure out your homework? But hey, we can bounce back from these feelings. Bouncing back isn't always about feeling happy. It's about finding healthy and safe ways to deal with being mad or sad or even worried. Let's look at four things you can do to help you bounce back when you're feeling angry or sad or worried. The first thing is to accept your feelings. Sometimes we get mad at ourselves for feeling mad or sad. But all emotions are okay. We all feel them from time to time. When you accept your feelings, you say to yourself, "It's okay, I'm feeling this way." This helps to remind you that all feelings are okay. The second thing is to cool down and calm your brain. Taking a few slow, deep breaths can help to calm our brains down so we can think more calmly and clearly about what is happening and about how we are feeling. The third thing we should do is talk kindly to ourselves. Because many times when we are feeling angry or frustrated, especially when we think something is hard or isn't going our way, our thoughts can become negative. But we should stay positive. Instead of saying, "This is too hard," we can say, "I can do this." Instead of saying, "This isn't fair," we can say, "Things always work out." You see, boys and girls, thinking positive things really help us to bounce back. And the last thing is to focus on good things. So when you're feeling down, stop and name three things that are going right. For example, think about your favorite lunch or snack that you would have today. Think about it, even when everything seems to be going wrong. Some things are going right. There are always things to be thankful for. Okay, boys and girls? Always remember, when things get tough and you feel upset, be resilient, just like a rubber ball, and bounce back.